in a rekindling of one of the great boys soccer rivalries in the News-Herald coverage area, Chagrin Falls and Kenston battled to a 1-1 stalemate on Saturday night over at Chagrin. Let's talk about the positives for both sides, and then we'll get to the elephant in the room. First, positives for Kenston. In the opening 40, I don't think there's any question that Chagrin had the better of the attack, but Kenston was very organized in the back, got nice matches out of their center back, Tyler Cooper, and their goalkeeper, Elliot Jones. Jones had some nice saves there in the first half to keep it a 0-0 match. Cooper was keeping that back line very organized, and they did a very solid job keeping this a 0-0 match while Chagrin was generating some quality there in their offensive third. I also think that something that Kenson did very well in the defensive third was making Chagrin standout striker Mac Mazzola go a bit deeper into the offensive third, over almost toward midfield, to get touches that maybe he's accustomed to. And if you're limiting a great striker like that in any way, shape, or form, a lot of Mac's touches were coming at the edge of the offensive third, and a lot of his shots were coming from distance. If you're doing that and limiting that young man in any way, that's a credit to your side, and I think that's certainly a credit to the Bombers and the way that they played in the defensive third. In the second half, the midfield work rate was just outstanding, and that really kept them in this match. Guys like CJ Maynard, maybe playing earlier in the match as a bit further back, maybe as a bit of a holding midfielder, and then moving up in a 4-4-2 to more of a classic center mid, winning balls in midfield and initiating the attack and some nice combo work. Guys like Dominic Bartolone and Hunter Neal, with their pace and their work rate through midfield into the offensive third, off the ball, on the ball, I think those guys really set a nice tone for the Bombers in the second half through midfield, and obviously there in the last 10 to 15 minutes, they controlled the attack, and they nearly got out of Chagrin with a result, and that really says a lot about this side. As far as Chagrin goes, that opening 40, like I said, they were outstanding in the offensive third, generating 6 shots on target, and they were dangerous in particular wide left. I thought that Joey Lustig and Jack Amendola in particular had some really nice dangerous runs there out wide left, testing the Bombers in the offensive third, getting some crosses there into the box, making some dangerous runs, getting throw-ins deep in their offensive third, and Lustig and Amendola certainly had a nice 80 minutes of work on this evening. And there in the second half, Chagrin also did well throughout this match in the defensive third. John Weber, for my money, is one of the best center backs in our area. I put him on the short list among the very, very best. So solid. Positioning, smartness, awareness, all of it. Smartness might not even be a word now that I think of it. Maybe intelligence is a better word, but be that as it may, we'll move on from that and just say that Weber is a very solid player. Mario can play him pretty much anywhere that he would like, and he's going to be very solid. He's certainly outstanding as a center back for the Tigers. Now the elephant in the room. All right, 65th minute. Kenston's Hunter Neal gets a touch at the top of the box, puts a shot on target, and much like Jeff Hurst in the 66 World Cup final, it dinks off the crossbar and down, and it's not ruled a goal. If I'm being honest, from my vantage point, and I had a pretty much unobstructed view of the play, looking at it myself, I believe it was a goal. The officials didn't think it was, the center ref didn't think it was, the linesman didn't think it was. I thought it was a goal, and it's unfortunate that we have to have situations like that because this was such a well-played match. But it is what it is, and hopefully both of these sides can do some damage in the postseason. If there's a better 3-6-3 side in our area than Kenston, I'd love to see it. When you're playing the kind of teams that they're playing, I'm not worried about Kenston at all. Their record is so deceiving. I mean, when you're playing Ignatius 2-1, that says all it needs to say about the quality of your side. And with Chagrin, they've been putting together some really nice, consistent soccer at times throughout this fall. It's a shame that they have to go to another district other than the area district for Division II. But hopefully we'll see some great things from these sides going forward after a 1-1 tie and another great chapter and one of the great rivalries in our coverage area in boys soccer on Saturday night.